Ready whenever you are.
You gave it to that last thing, and does that guy up and down like he's on a rubber band.
We didn't really weigh the 134.
And a couple of pounds for breakfast, the way those guys always eat, that brings it up to 136. Keep it up and you'll get the spring out of it. We want this one's next boat.
All right.
Things out of the window.
We're playing with that gallant.
I didn't expect us to do any work.
Get out there yelling. I'll get the sheriff after you, tramp.
They must respect for the press around here. How's the wife, Ed? Any better?
Worse. And me having to hang around all day and all night waiting for him to hang that cuckoo.
Hard work, Aura.
Crank it for a dime. Hey, Schwartz, what do you do?
Why me? What time is it anyway?
4:30. Hey, me too. These cards are like wash rags. Let's chip in and get a new deck.
These are good enough for me. I'm 80 cents out already.
Faber, 1059. Hey, take this phone. Ernie, you ain't doing anything. You guys crippled or something? Criminal court building, press room. Just a minute, please. Hello, Sarge. McHugh. Yeah, I phoned. Anything doing? All right. Thank you, Sarge.
To Jern. Say, Ernie, why don't you take your instrument into the library and play it?
Hello. Is this the home of Mrs. F.D. Margolis? This is Mr. McHugh with the City News Bureau. Is it true, madam, that you were the victim of a peeping Tom?
Ask her if she's worth peeping at.
Oh, now, madam, that ain't the right attitude to take. All we want is the facts.
Tell her I can run up for an hour.
Tell her to come over here. We'd like to reenact the crime.
Just a minute, madam. Is it true, Mrs. Margolis, that you took the part of Lady Godiva for charity 7 years ago? Hello? She cut off.
What, her hair? Tell her I'll be right over.
Yep. No, he'll be counting it.
Oh, hello, Mr. Burns. No, Hilly hasn't shown up yet. Yeah, sure, Mr. Burns.
Hello, Mansinger. I just had an interview with Williams over in that death house.
That jail is reeking with germs. Oh, believe me, the Board of Health is going to hear about the conditions over there through my paper. It's amazing to me that those prisoners can live long enough to get home.
What's the idea, Mac?
Say, is that the only telephone in this place?
The only one that allows me.
How many times have I got to tell you fellas to let my phone alone? You want to talk to a mouthpiece? Go and buy one like I did.
Whitney, 9,000.
The germs of the mouth are the most contagious.
Oh, shut up, Listerine. Whitney, 9,000.
What is this, a hospital?
Yeah, Roy, how's your simple coming along?
Hello, Sarge. McHugh. Anything doing?
Say, you don't have to use my desk for a garbage can either.
Say, how'd you like to stop stinking up this place with those antiseptics?
Yeah, anything new on the hand, Benson?
My deal, ain't it?
Hey, Zonite.
What is it?
Question before the house. Gentleman wants to know if there's anything new on the hanging.
Oh, nothing special.
Did you talk to the sheriff?
Why don't you get your own news?
Somebody ought to see the sheriff.
Criminal court's press room.
No, Hilly Counseling.
Oh, yes, Mr. Burns.
What?
No, Mr. Burns. Yes, Mr. Burns. Goodbye, Mr. Burns.
Walter Burns for Hilly again. Something must have happened.
I'll tell you what's happened. Hilly's quit.
Oh, nurse. You know, Hilly's a fixture on the Morning Post.
Yeah, he goes with the Woodward.
Well, he told me he was going to quit.
Say, listen, Walter Burns wouldn't let him quit.
He'll find a way to keep him here somehow.
Remember what he did to Fenton when he wanted to go to Hollywood?
Got him into a fight and had him thrown into jail for assault and battery.
You mean a rewrite?
Well, if he ain't quit, why ain't he here covering the hangar? I wish I could quit.
Ready? Nurse Isabel Zobo. Z for zebra, O for onion, B for baptized, E for anything, L for...
Oh, don't tell him anybody.
L for Listerine. Swedish masseuse, with rooms at 608 Inverness Avenue. Well, this dame was arrested tonight on complaint of a lot of angry wives. They claim she's been treating their husbands with electricity at $1 a time.
Well, the Swedish teeth is in again. I understand she massages them, too.
Well, anyway, she's arrested. And the station house is full of her patients claiming she's innocent. Half the stock exchange is there, too, trying to provide bail. All right. Bain, 6800.
Say, Ernie, why don't you take up electricity instead of that noise?
Oh, it's got no future.
Press? No, Mr. Burns. Hildy Johnson is. I'm not lying, Mr. Burns. Walter acted like he'd burst a blood vessel.
Johnson, sir?
No.
Then I'll have to put another man on the job.
In your hat, Duffy. I'm after that bunch of lily-livered, pockmarked peanut politicians who think they're running this town. And Hildy Johnson's the only man on the staff I can trust tonight.
But we've got to have
We've got to have Johnson.
But you haven't got it.
Johnson here?
He's on the wagon.
I ain't. You remember me? I was here last night with Mr. Bensley.
Mr. Bensley's still here.
Great.
Hey, baby. Oh, hey, Doc. You seen the Hildy Johnson?
I haven't seen
Don't you get a look at Walter Burns' face when he hears of this? Oh, I'd write it for a year to see when he hears I'm getting married. Oh, I'd write it for 2 years to get a lot of what he says when I'm leaving this town. I left New York. What's the matter?
Oh, so that's why you got that. Walter Burns. That's why you're going to marry me, Walter Burns. That's why you're going to New York, to spite Walter Burns.
Oh, honey, you're crazy. Now, listen. Listen, did you ever come up out of a sewer... Did you ever come up? Did you ever come up out of a sewer and have the cool, fresh air hit you? Well, I did. And honey, you're the cool, fresh air. You've made a fresh air fiend out of me, dear.
And I'm not going back there unless you send me.
Then, Hildy, you go right up to Walter Burns and resign.
Well, and have him get his hands on me? That's why I've been hiding out at your place, to keep away from that double-crossing maniac. Tell you what I'll do. I'll resign by phone and to get a look at that snake's face.
Oh, no, you don't. Here.
What, 500 and one bill?
Uncle sent it to me for a wedding present. I wasn't going to give it to you until we got there. But you take it. After you take me home, you get the ticket. Instead of getting married tonight, we'll get married tomorrow. Instead of going to New York tomorrow, we'll go to New York tonight.
All we have to do is throw the oil underwear in the trunk 24 hours earlier, that's all.
What is it, Mother? Do you know what I think?
What?
I think you must be a sort of irresponsible type, or you wouldn't do things this way. Now, Mother, you stop picking on my Hildy. He didn't do one blessed thing to help our getting away. You better get busy.
Okay.
Listen,
honey, when I'm downtown, I'll get those tickets to see the mother gets the floor. See you later.
Hildy!
Oh, Hildy. I'd like to have a little talk with you for about 15 minutes. Not a chance, Walter. I'm You're not too busy to be playing around the neighborhood turning in false fire alarms.
What?
Hello, Mac.
Come on, Mr. Burns.
All right, Walter. Boy, I wish I could find the guy that did this. I'd make that box his tombstone.
Aren't you going to ask me how I found out where you were?
Yeah, great scoop with everybody in the county building working
and
for
you. I was just warming up a hot cake.
Set him up.
None for me.
He'll take the same.
So you're leaving me for marriage?
Why?
None of your business.
How'd it happen?
There was a moon.
Well, I guess that lets me out.
I'll give you a farewell party.
Thanks.
But it hurts, Hildy.
You're not telling a fellow after all I've done for you.
You mean after all you've done to me? By the time you sent me down the lake to test that trick diving suit. That suit was about as waterproof as your straw hat. Filled so fast, it took me half an hour to pull me up. It was lucky I only went deaf.
Didn't I go to the expense of hiring an airplane to pick you up so you could get your hearing back?
And at the further expense of bribing the pilot to land him in the middle of a strike massacre at Heron, Illinois?
You scooped the whole world on the story. You made yourself the envy of every newspaper man alive.
Oh, well, it was worth it, sir. Even if I did get ridden out of town in the rail, were they full of holes in a hat that cost me $6?
And charged on the expense account at 15?
And got away with it?
Ah, those are the days. You'll certainly have a lot to tell the kids.
Yeah.
What kids? You're getting married. No, why not? A guy's got to settle down sometime. Get a home and wife. And actually, his kids will hold it all together.
That's right. I was never big enough to let a nice girl reform me so I could stay in a two-room love nest at nights with a wife and kids while the fellas were out having a lot of fun. Oh, dear. Marriage does make a respectable citizen out of a man. It must be grand. None of this idiotic jumping around at all hours and having to be on the inside of all the crazy excitement in this town. The 5:15 out to some quiet suburb. A home-cooked dinner every night at exactly 7, and by 10 in bed. Unless, after the tapioca, the wife has a few friends in for a neighborly chat. I don't blame you, Hildy. It sounds great.
Excuse me a minute, will
you? Come on, there, Sporty. Deal them out, boy. Don't let that deck get cold.
See if you can deal me a decent hand, will you?
Well, with the shoes. Any news?
I just been over to the death house. Did you hear what Williams said to the priest?
Oh, forget it. Yeah, I know. The paper's full of the hanging. We ain't got room for the ads. What did Williams say?
He said that...
Come on, boys, ante up. Ante up.
I've ante twice already. He said to the priest that he was innocent.
He'll start crying in a minute.
Why don't you send the poor nut some roses like that girl of his, Molly Malloy?
Oh, now, there you are. There's an idea.
She thinks she's innocent, too.
Oh, you fellas don't understand.
Now,
before you go on, wouldn't you, would you mind running down to the corner and getting me a hamburger sandwich?
Personally, my feeling is...
They said two hamburgers like a good fellow.
Now, my feeling is that Williams is of the dual personality type.
Yeah, I know. Like the Dolly sister.
Yeah, tell it to the Tribune.
Great.
All right. That's true. It's on account of the way his head is shaped. It's a typical case.
Oh.
Ask him to put a lot of ketchup on them sandwiches. I thought you fellas might be interested in the psychological end.
Make my plain lettuce on gluten bread.
Get me a sandwich too, wouldn't you?
I raise you.
Well, it's drop right now.
Where am I going to get the dough for all these eats?
Oh, charge it.
You got a badge, haven't you? What's it good for?
4 hamburgers and a letter.
On gluten?
L.O. Hello, Mr. Burns. Why, no, we haven't seen Hildy.
I have, friend.
Look at your
face.
It's Walter Burns on the wire. Talk to him, will you, Hildy? That paranoid could take a sweet kiss for himself. Come on, Ernie, sound your aid. Goodbye forever.
Listen, Hildy, will you do me a personal favor and talk to Walter?
He's been calling up about 9 million times.
What's the matter, Hildy? Are you afraid of him?
I'll talk to that maniac with pleasure. Hello, Mr. Burns. What's that, Mr. Burns? Why, your language is shocking, Mr. Burns. Say, listen, you crazy baboon. Get a pencil and paper and take this down and get it straight because it's important. This is the Hildy Johnson curse. The next time I see you, no matter where I am or what I'm doing, I'm going to walk right up to you and hammer on that monkey skull of yours till it rings like a Chinese gong.
Oh, boy.
That's telling him.
Listen.
Hey,
I'm just trying to see you
over there. No, I ain't going to cover the hanging. I wouldn't cover Washington crossing the Delaware for you. That'd be did it all over again. Never mind the Vaseline, Jocko. It won't do you any good this time because I'm going to New York. I didn't tell you that, did I? But if you know what's good for you, you'll stay west of Gary, Indiana, because the Johnson never forgets. And that, boys, is what is known as telling the managing editor.
Well, why'd you quit?
Getting married. See those three to New York tonight.
Tonight?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean, three?
Me and my girl and her darling ma.
Oh, look, he's in love. Does he what say?
Is she a fight girl?
Has she got a good shape?
Does Walter know you're getting married?
Does he know? shook hands like a pal, offered to throw me a farewell dinner.
That's his favorite joke, farewell dinner.
He poisons people at him. He Tucker 2164 with his. Yeah, he got me into Pulock, Mike. Filled me full of cheap booze. I'd have been there yet if it hadn't been for the window. You imagine that guy trying to break up my marriage after shaking hands? Oh, hello, Peggy. How are you, darling? Hmm? Well, I know, but... Oh, you bet I resigned right in his face, didn't I?
Yeah.
What? 11:18 tonight. The press room. Just dropped in to say goodbye to the boys. Yeah. No, not a chance, honey. I got a taxi waiting. Yeah. 10 minutes. Bye-bye, honey.
Hey, where's the wedding?
In New York. So you guys ain't gonna have any fun with it. No fake warrants. You're kidnapping the bride with me.
Everybody's getting a New York grave. I think it's a stinking village.
On the count, Hildy, they tell me all the reporters in New York use lipstick.
Remember that one last summer? With a topper?
Oh, what day was the man? Could any of you gentlemen tell me where the telegraph office is? You want the car, Hildy, you'll be talking like that.
Which one of those New York papers are you going to work for?
None of them. Who wants to work in a newspaper? Now, the whole boat is full of dandruff and bad gin. They wait a lot of all of them.
What are you going in for, the movie?
The advertising business. $150 a week.
What? $150 what?
There's the contract.
If you guys got anything better to do down there?
It is $150.
You're going to miss a sweet hanging.
Not if he's going to write poetry about my lady's panties.
Can you imagine punching a time clock, sitting around with a lot of stuffed shirts, talking statistics?
Why, you'll be like a fire horse tied to a milk wagon.
Listen to who's talking. Journalists. Peeking through keyholes. Running after fire engines like a lot of coat storms. Waking people up in the middle of the night to ask them what they think of Mussolini. Stealing pictures off of old ladies with their daughters to get attacked at Grove Park. A lot of dandy buddinskis swimming around with holes in their pants. Borrowing nickels from office boys. And for what? So a million hired girls and motormen's wives don't know what's going on.
Yeah, your girl must have handed you that line.
I don't have to have anybody tell me about a newspaper. I've been a newspaper man for 15 years. Cross between a bootlegger and a galooper. If you want to know something, you'll all end up on a copy desk. Gray-haired, humpback slobs, dodging debt collectors when you're 90.
You'll be out on the street the minute your contract's up.
Not me. My girl's uncle owns the business.
Has he got a lot of jack?
Choking on. What do you think he give us for a wedding present?
A dozen doilies.
$500 in cash.
There is $500 in cash.
There it is. That's what it costs to get those tickets to New York.
Ooh. Let me count it.
Oh, no, you don't.
Just a minute. Just a minute, boys.
What about a little bite? Garam. Jenny.
Hello.
Hey.
America.
Can I wash up now, please?
Yes. This place is beginning to smell like an owl's foot. You don't want to wash up on a night like this. Jenny, this is a holiday. Come on, give us a kiss.
You really don't keep away from me.
What's the matter? Ain't I your fella anymore?
Oh.
Tell you what we'll do, Jenny. You and I will go around and say goodbye to everybody in the building. Oh, but we can't carry this all over. Come on, Jenny. Come on. Hey! Look! Come on, Jenny. You and I will say goodbye to the warden.
No, we'll do something.
Why, I own this building. Well, see you around again, Jenny.
Around
again. Look here, fellas. Hello, fellas. Now,
hey.
Who jumped that out of this window?
We promised not.
Who threw it?
Judge Mankiewicz threw it.
He was in here with his robes on, playing fireman. Come on now, fellas. I know who it was. It was Hildy Johnson, wasn't it? Where is he?
Out with a lady.
I swear I don't know what to do with you fellas. I've a darn good mind to take this press room away from you.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Wouldn't that be too bad? Well, the place is so full of cockroaches, you can't walk.
Personally, I don't give two hoots. But how do you suppose it looks to have a lot of hoodlums yelling and throwing things out of the window? There's someone in that get up. How do you suppose he feels listening to all this revelry?
A lot you care how he feels.
We're doing everything possible to
take... get your whole ticket re-elected next week.
Yes, when Earl Williams drops through that trap tomorrow, it means a million votes.
Can we help it if the people rise to support this administration's stand against the Red Menace?
Personified by Mr. Earl Williams, the guy who loses the job he's held for 14 years, joins a parade of the unemployed, and because he's goofy from lack of food, waves a red undershirt.
Williams is a dangerous radical, and he killed a policeman.
Williams is a poor bird who has the tough luck to kill a colored policeman in a town where their colored vote's important.
And they're hanging Andy Deaver in the morning.
You!
Keep your shirt on, Pinky.
And I don't want to hear any more of that Pinky stuff. I got a name, see? Peter B. Hartman. Stop it! Pinky, how's that look to the voters? Like I had sore eyes or something.
Just a minute, fellows, just a minute. Now, Pete, how about the favor that certain party is asking? Once and for all, will you hang this person at 5 a.m. instead of 7? It can't hurt you, and we can make the city addition.
Roy, you can't hang a man in his sleep just to please the newspaper.
No, but you can keep postponing the hanging so it'll come just before the election.
Yes.
With this new alienist coming in, how do we know there'll be a hanging?
Yes. What if this professor finds he's insane or something?
Yes.
Well, he won't find he's insane.
No?
No, because he ain't. Williams is as sane as I am.
Saner.
Yes.
Now, here's a resume of the situation. The newspapers have got to put their shoulders to the wheel. They've got to impress on these Bolsheviks that a death warrant for Earl Williams is a death warrant for every bomb thrown on American Red in this town. This hanging means more to the people of our fair city today. That's a statement, Jimmy.
Why don't you go home?
All right, you'll just get scooped. Grizzled reform the Reds with a rope. That's our slogan. You can quote me if you want to. Sheriff Hartman pledges.
Oh, Peoria, we've been printing this chestnut for weeks.
Ain't you going to use that?
Sure.
Give me the desk. This is Bensinger. The sheriff refuses to move the hanging up a minute.
No, I won't. That hanging's coming off exactly as per schedule. 7 o'clock in the morning and not a minute sooner. There's such a thing as being humane, you know.
All right. All right. Which way do you want a favor? Give me a rewrite.
7 o'clock in the morning.
Jake, you lead on the hanging. And say, Jake, don't use Hartman's name in this at all. Just say the sheriff.
Why can't this jerk these guys at a reasonable hour so we can get some sleep?
This new alienist, Dr. Mac J. Engelhofer. That's right, from Vienna. He's going to examine Williams at the request of the United Federation for World Betterment. Oh, my, one of the biggest. Author of that book, The Personality Gland.
And where to put it?
At a dime. Just autograph the copy for me.
Did he write his initials in your pants, too?
Wait. There's more.
That doctor's the 14th pair of whiskers they've sent in on this case.
Say, those aliens make me sick. All they do is push you, then send you a bill for $500.
Give me the desk. Now, Jake, here's the situation on the eve of the hanging.
Hello, this is Murphy. More slop on the hanging.
The jail, the municipal buildings, the railroad terminals, and elevated stations to prepare for the expected general uprising of radicals at the hour of execution.
Sheriff Hartman has just put 400 more relatives on the payroll to protect the city against the Red Menace, which is leaving Moscow in a couple of minutes.
Up a dime. Sheriff Hartman, the sheriff, has just received 4 more letters threatening his life, which he's going to answer by a series of raids.
Prove to the voters that the Red Menace is on the square. Sheriff Hartman has just written himself 4 more letters threatening his life. Yes, yes, I know he wrote them on account of the misspelling.
Drop. That's all, Jake. Except the condemned man ate a hearty dinner. Mock turtle soup, chicken pot pie, hash brown potatoes, combination salad, and pie, a la mode.
The doomed man ate a hearty meal as follows. noodle soup, roast the beef, sweet a potato, cranberry sauce, strawberry pie, and a great big hunk of pastrami.
Statement from who?
The sheriff?
Oh, quote him for anything you want.
He can't read.
Kruger calling. Nothing new on the hanging.
And say, Jake, get this in as a big favor for me, will you? The whole meal was furnished by Charlie Apfel. A for adenoids, P for psychology, F for phenomen, E for epilepsy, and lay an egg. Certainly this is Bensinger talking. Well, the proprietor of Apfel wants to see you, restaurant. That's it, yes. Thank you.
I think Bensinger's going in for petty graft again.
That means a new hat for somebody.
I understand that's how Bensinger gets all his clothes.
Sure, the greasy spoon gave him that overcoat when George Kidd Q-Corps swung.
If they ever stop hanging people, they'll probably go naked.
Why don't you make a poem out of it, Roy?
Hello, Mike.
Uh-oh, there's a gleam in her eye.
Don't look at me, sweetheart. I never said a word.
Hello, kid. How's the old Selena again?
Short, and how are you, Molly?
Been looking for you, tramp.
Kid, those are swell roses you sent, Earl. What do you want done with them tomorrow morning?
A lot of wise guys, ain't you?
What do you want in here?
To tell you what I think of you. All of you.
Keep your skirts on.
You was worth breaking my fingernails on. I tell your face wide open.
What's the matter, sweetheart? What are you sore about? Now, wasn't that a swell story we gave you?
Yeah. You crumbs have been making a fool out of me long enough.
She oughtn't to be allowed in here. Yesterday, I caught her using the drinking cup.
Never said I loved Earl Williams and was willing to marry him on the gallows. You made that up. About my being his soulmate and having a love nest with him.
You've been sucking around that cuckoo ever since he's been in the death house. Everybody knows you're his affinity.
That's a rotten lie. I met Mr. Williams just once in my life. He was wandering around in the rain without his hat and coat on like a sick dog the day before the shooting. I went up to him like any human being would, and asked him what was the matter. He told me about being fired after working at the same place for 14 years. I took him up to my room because it was warm there.
Oh. Put that on your Victrola.
Just because you want to fill your lying papers with a lot of dirty scandal, you got to torture him. Make a tramp out of me.
Got a match?
I tell you, he just sat there talking to me all night. Never once laid a hand on me.
Uh-oh.
In the morning, he went away. I never saw him again until that day at the trial.
Tell us what you told the jury.
Go on, laugh. I'd like to know some curses bad enough for your greedy souls. Sure, I was his witness, the only one he had.
Witness?
Yes, me, Molly Malloy, a common streetwalker. The only one with nerve enough to stand up for him. That's why you persecuted me. Because he treated me decent, not like an animal, and I said so.
When do you dance, kid? This is the press room. We're busy.
Why don't you go and see your boyfriend?
Better hurry. He's left a call for 7 a.m.
You wonder a bolt of lightning don't come down and strike you all dead. What was that?
They're fixing up a pain in the neck for your boyfriend.
Oh,
oh, what's the idea?
Oh.
Oh, now. Don't get hysterical.
Oh, shame on you.
Why, I didn't say anything.
A poor, crazy little guy. Never did anybody any harm. Sitting out there alone this minute with the angel of death beside him. And you cracking jokes.
Say, listen, if you don't shut up, I'll give you something to cry about.
Oh, keep your dirty hands off of
come
me.
Come on, outside. Outside, Sam. Come on, get out of here. Get out. Take it on the lamb.
Say, listen, your greedy soul.
Well, do you guys want to play some more poker?
Here now, tickets for the hanging. Two for each paper.
What do you mean, two?
What do you want to do, take your family?
Hey, listen, Pete, our boss wants a couple for the advertising department.
I promised to pay it. This ain't the Follies, you know.
Oh.
big-hearted Pinky. I'm getting tired of your editors using these tickets to get advertising accounts.
You got a lot of nerve. Everybody knows you use them to get in socially.
Yeah, you had the whole Union League Club over at the last hanging.
Trying to suck in with the swells, huh?
I suppose you'll wear a monocle tomorrow morning.
Now, boys, that ain't the way to talk. If any of you want a couple of extra tickets, I'll be more than glad to take care of you. But for goodness sake, don't kill.
Hiya, boys. We cleaned up.
Here, here, here. Get that copy of the Morning Post out of here.
Look here, Johnson. What do you mean by throwing things out of the window? Johnson, what do you mean by throwing things out of the window? Who do you think you are?
Who wants to know?
You think that you're all the birds around this town? Well, I'm going to send a bill to the folks tomorrow for all the wreckage been committed around here in the last year. Now, how do you like that?
That's swell. You know what else you can do?
What?
Get.
You stick your nose to this building tomorrow, I'll have you arrested.
Well, that's almost worth staying for.
And I'll tell you something else, and you can pass it on to Walter Burns. The Post get no tickets for this hanging on account of the lies that they've been printing.
Well, listen, you pot roast, if I want to go to your hanging, I'll go, see, and I'll sit in a box.
Oh, no, you won't.
All you have to tell half of what I know.
You don't know anything.
I happen to know who occupied room 602 at a certain hotel the night before the last hanging.
Oh. That hotel crack has doubled them up.
Say, Sheriff.
Rest room.
Just what hotel was that?
For you, Sheriff.
Sheriff Hartman talking. Oh, hello, dear.
It must be Irma.
No, I can't come home. I got too many things to do. Getting ready for the hanging.
Why don't you take him out to your house and hang him?
I'll call you up later, Irma.
It is Irma.
I gotta see an alienist. No, alienist. Not for me, for William.
Restroom. Who? Hey, Hildy, your girl.
Hello, you.
Hello, Peggy. How are you, Darren?
Yay,
staying
wicked.
Oh,
how about my
plate
letter?
Hamburger
for me.
I ordered one, didn't I?
You did not. That's where it wasn't chosen. Why, darling, what's the matter?
I distinctly said gluten.
Listen, darling, I just dropped in to say goodbye to the fellas. You remember I told you? Say, will you guys talk or something?
All right.
Yes, I've got a taxi waiting.
Hey, go easy on that ketchup. I'm responsible for it.
We are. I've got the tickets right in my pocket. Now, listen, dear, if you talk like that, I'm going to go right out and jump in the lake. I swear I will, because I can't stand it. Listen.
We're listening.
I love you. I said I love you.
Oh, give him a break, Ernie.
Well, that's more like it. You feel better now? Well, smile. Say something. You know what I want to hear. Tell me you love me. Come on, tell me you love me.
Tell him you love me, and we'll all go to sleep.
That's the stuff. Yep. Listen, honey, will you wear that little blue straw hat?
Wait a minute, I'll see.
Well, are you happy now? Well, I bet you're not as happy as I am. Well, I bet you anything you want. All right, dear. Yeah. 5 minutes. Bye-bye.
Hildy, here's Warner again. Tell him to give us a rest, will you?
Oh. Hey, you're just making a nuisance out of yourself. What's the idea of calling up on us? What? No, I'm through with newspapers. I'm going to New York tonight, right now, this minute.
Hey, Hildy, stick that among your souvenirs.
Hey, Hildy, you'll get us in an awful jam.
If the boy calls up again, tell him to put it in writing and send it to Hildebrand Johnson, Waterbury Adams Corporation, 735 Fifth Avenue, New York City.
Please, Sheriff. Huh? Please.
Oh, excuse me, Professor.
I ain't afraid to die. I ain't afraid.
Don't work too much the first day, kid.
Goodbye, Johnson.
I'll drop your line, Hildy, and let you know what Walter says.
So long, Hildy.
Be careful of that treacherous New York weather, Hildy.
So long, Grant. Don't forget to send us a postal card. Don't forget to drop in and see us if you ever come back, kid.
Well, we see you again, Hildy.
Riding in a Rolls Royce, giving out interviews on Success.
Now we shall reenact the crime. With your gun, Sheriff. Gun. Now imagine that I am the policeman. You understand? I am the policeman. Now where exactly did you stand? Show me.
Hey, Hildy, I hope you got a return trip ticket. You'll be back next week.
And then what did you do? Dementia, Freecox!
Goodbye, you wage slaves. When you're calling up fire escapes, getting kicked out of front doors, eating Christmas dinners in one-arm joints, don't forget your old pal, Hildy Johnson. As the road beyond unfolds... The gun. He ran up 8 flights of stairs to the infirmary, got out through the skylight. He must have slid down the rain pipe to the street.
Murphy, give me the desk.
No, I tell you, no one knows where he got it. Call you back.
No clue yet to Earl Williams' whereabouts. The crime commission is offering a $10,000 reward for the capture of Earl Williams. Call you back.
Hello? Hello, here's a feature for you. Tear bomb. Yes, yes, tear bomb. Criminals cry for it.
If the mayor wants me, he knows where I am.
This bomb went off accidentally in the hands of Sheriff Hartman's bombing squad.
What went off?
The following deputy sheriffs were taken to the emergency hospital.
A fine fair weather friend you are.
Winnie J. Glazer.
After all I've done for you.
Herman Wallstein.
Putting things like that in the paper.
Sidney Matt.
That's gratitude for you.
And Danny Koo.
Kruger calling.
McKill, give me the desk.
A man answering Williams' description was seen boarding a southbound Cottage Grove Avenue car by motorman Julius A. Lindbergh.
Sidelights on a manhunt.
Yeah, Lindbergh. I thought it'd make a swell feature on account of the name.
Mrs. Richard Watts, Jr., age 55, scrub lady. While at work scrubbing the 8th floor of the Commerce Building, was shot in the left leg by one of Sheriff Hartman's special deputies.
I'll rush right after it.
For the scrub lady.
Can he joke in and hurry get out?
All I can get the sheriff let him out because he can vote for him.
Where do you suppose Williams got that gun?
Give me water burns, quick. Hello, Walter. Hildy. I just got the whole story from Jacoby.
Exclusive?
Right, that's a pip. Only get this, it cost me $260, see?
Don't waste time. Give me the story.
I'm telling you. First, I had to give Jacoby all the money I had on me, and it wasn't exactly mine, and I want it back.
How'd he get the gun?
You hear what I said about the money?
Yes, go on.
All right, then. Boy, this is the jailbreak of your dreams. This profound thinker from Vienna decided to make Williams reenact the crime.
Well, well, well.
Well, I'm coming to it, will you shut up? Of course, he had to have a gun to reenact it with. And who do you suppose supplied it?
Who?
Peter B. Hartman, B for brains. No, I'm not kidding. The sheriff gave his gun to the professor gave it to Earl, and Earl shot the professor right in the belly.
The professor's in the hospital. Williams has evaporated, and the sheriff's gone nuts. Ain't it perfect?
Fine work, Gildy.
Save the violets. I want that money. $260. No, I tell you, I'm not going to cover anything else. I'm going away. Listen, that's the money I'm going to get married on. I just did it as a personal favor. I'm going to leave town tonight. Listen, I gave Jacoby every cent I had at... Well, all right, when will you send it over?
Right away.
Well, tell him to hurry. I'll wait for him here. Okay. Oh, hello, Peggy. How are you, darling?
What was that?
Oh, I was just telling Walter I was through, that's all.
You haven't done something foolish with our mother?
Oh, no, no.
Then I think I'd better take care of it from now on.
Oh, now, listen, sweetheart, everything's going to be perfectly all right.
And you haven't got it?
Well, no, not right now, but he's going to send it over. Walter, I mean. The boy will be here any minute.
Oh, yeah. Oh, kill me.
Listen, honey, I wouldn't have had this happen for the world. Look, if this is what happened, I would...
I know.
Well, I can't tell you if you won't listen. I had to give Jacoby the money so he wouldn't give the story to the other papers.
Every time I wanted you for something. My birthday. New Year's Eve when I waited up till 5 in the morning.
Oh, I know, but a big story broke.
It's always a big story. The biggest story in the world. And the next day everybody's forgotten it, even you.
What do you mean, forgotten? That was the Clara Hammond murder on your birthday. Oh, for heaven's sake, Peggy, it won't hurt to wait just a few minutes, and the boy's on his way with the money now.
Mother's downstairs in a taxi. I'm just ashamed to face her. If she knew about that money. It's all we've got in the world, Hilly. We haven't even got a place to sleep except the train.
Listen, honey, I'll tell you what we'll do. You and Mother go and have the baggage checked. There are the tickets.
You mean you're not coming?
Sure, I'm coming. I'll meet you at the information booth.
It's all that Walter Byrne. You simply can't resist it.
Him, I wouldn't raise a finger if he was dying.
McHugh talking.
Oh, hello, Mac. Dear, this is Mr. McHugh. Mac, this is my girl.
Pleased to meet you. Here's a feature on the manhunt that'll knock you right on you. Excuse me, miss.
Wait a second, honey.
Mrs. Phoebe DeWolf, 861 and a half South Euclid Street, color. Well, she became the mother of a pickaninny in a patrol wagon with Sheriff Hartman's rifle squad acting as nurses.
Huh?
Oh, you should have seen her, miss.
Come on, dear, we'll put our things in the cab.
Well, Phoebe was walking along the street when all of a sudden she began... Right. So they coaxed her into the patrol wagon and started a race with the store. When the pickaninny was born, the rifle squad examined him carefully to see if it was Earl Williams, who they knew was hiding somewhere. They named the kid Peter Hartman DeWolf in honor of the sheriff. And they all pitched in $1 apiece on account of it being the first baby ever born on a manhunt. Wait a minute. Here's the mayor himself. Maybe there's a statement.
Don't pester me now, please. I have a lot on my mind.
His honor won't say anything.
Have you seen Sheriff Hartman?
No. What effect is this jailbreak going to have on the colored voters?
Not an iota. In what way can an unavoidable misfortune of this sort influence the duty of every citizen, colored or otherwise?
Ah, you're right. Tell me, is there a red menace or ain't there?
Hartman, I've been looking for you.
So have we. What's it all, Pinky?
Who engineered this getaway?
Just a minute, fellas. We got him located.
Williams? Where?
Where he used to live. The rifle squad just starting out. You can catch him if you hurry.
Pete! I want to talk to you.
I ain't got time, Fred, honest. I'll see you after.
Pete! Did you actually give Williams that gun?
Well, the professor asked me for it. I thought it was for something scientific.
Pete!
Kruger calling. Here's a red-hot statement from the governor. The governor says the mayor and the sheriff have shown themselves to be a couple of 8-year-olds playing with fire. Quote them as follows. It's a good thing for the city that next Tuesday is election day, as the citizens will thus be saved the expense of impeaching the mayor and the sheriff. That's all. Hi, Your Honor.
Speak. I've got a mighty unpleasant task to perform.
You're just going to get me rattled, Fred. Born in 400 deputies.
Do you want to bankrupt this administration?
But I'm getting them for only $12 a night.
$12 for those romantic cousins of yours. Out there, shooting up everybody they can see for the fun of it.
But
You're through. Now, don't appeal to my sentimental side.
I don't know what to say, Fred. A thing of this kind almost ruins a man's faith in human nature.
Faith?
And our families, Fred. I've always looked on Betty as my own sister.
If there was any way out.
But there is a way out. Just give me a couple hours, will you? Hello. 400 suppers, nothing doing. This is a manhunt, not a banquet. That $12 covers everything. That gives you an idea what I'm up against.
We're up against a lot more than that with that nutty slogan you invented. Reform the rich with a rope.
It's for me. I'm Sheriff Hartman. You looking for me?
You certainly are a hard man to find.
Huh?
I've been
looking. What do you want?
I'm a messenger at the State House. This is from the governor.
What's from the governor?
The reprieve for Earl Williams.
For whom?
Earl Williams, the reprieve.
And the governor gave me his word of honor that he wouldn't interfere 2 days ago.
And you fell for it. Pete, it frightens me what I'd like to do to you.
He's gone.
Was there anybody here for me?
No, Mr. Johnson.
Oh, that double-crossing louse.
Everything will be all right. Now, don't worry. All we want to do is ask you a couple of questions.
The trouble is nobody's using the right psychology of...
You got $260?
No, sir. But I got a way of making it. And more. Cherchez la femme.
What?
Who is it that's been defending Williams? Hanging around.
Oh, I ain't got time for that trip. I got to get $260 in the next 5 minutes.
Take longer than 5 minutes to get it. I know where Williams is.
Sure, he's out getting his head blown off with a rifle squad, but that don't get me my dough.
He's with that girl, Molly Malloy. That's where...
Oh, shut up!
Remember, you never delivered this. You got caught in a traffic jam or something. Don't let anybody see you.
Yeah, but how do I know?
Come and see me at my office tomorrow. What is your name? Pincus. All right, Mr. Pincus. All you got to do is to lay low and keep your mouth shut. Here. You go to this address. It's a nice, homey little place, and
you can get anything you want.
Tell them Fred sent you. Okay, Fred.
You imagine Wooden Shoes? This kind of more, I'd have been a gentleman. I'll ask Louise, you got the dough?
Huh? She sent him a lot of roses, didn't she?
Yeah. Stick your roses. Come on, Louie, I'm in a hurry.
I'll bet you I'm right.
Oh, you... No, not you.
Hey, look, what are you talking about?
Then Walter sent you over here?
Sure, in case you need any help.
Yeah, we know, but $260.
What's the $260?
The money I spent on the story. Walter promised to send it over, but I can't wait, Soros.
So what?
Listen, Louie, you almost got a lot of dough on you.
Oh, so you want them from me, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. It's a lot of money, you know what I mean?
Oh, Louie, my whole future depends on this. My girl's waiting at the trailer. Going to New York tonight. I've only got 15 minutes. If you'd help me out in this, I swear that I'll...
Look, Walter's going to give it to me the works. He'll need my help if you turn out on him.
Oh, no, he knows I'm going. I just did him a swell favor and we're pals again.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do with you. I'm going to take the chance.
Oh, that's the stuff. I'm on that boy to give the water and you can get the money for him. You're a white man, Louie.
Tell you what I'll do. I'll give you $150 for the debt.
Hey, wait a minute. That's taking advantage.
Well, it's the best of what I can do.
I lose almost $100 that way.
That's $110 you lose.
Hey, Louie, give me $200, will you?
$150.
All right, give me the dough.
Anyways. Hey, look. What he says on here?
Well, you read what he says on there.
Oh, sure, that's right. Well, goodbye and good luck. Oh. I'm going to look you up in New York if there's anything wrong with this. You know what I mean?
Oh, well, anyway, I get
out of this place.
Excuse me.
Put down that gun!
It ain't loaded. I fired all the bullets already.
I surrender. I couldn't hang off of the roof any longer. I ain't afraid to die. I was telling the fellow that when he handed me the gun. Waking me up in the middle of the night. Talking to me about things they don't understand. Calling me a Bolshevik. I'm an anarchist. It's got nothing to do with bombs. It's the philosophy that guarantees every man freedom. All those poor people being crushed by the system. And the boys that were killed in the war. And in the slums. All of those slaves to a crust of bread. I can hear them crying.
Shut up a second, will you?
Go on. Go on, take me back. Hang me. I've done my best.
Give me water, Burns, quick.
Yeah, right.
Hello. Oh, hello, Peggy. Now listen, dear, please, something terrific has happened. Don't start to phone me out now. Wait a minute, will you? Hello, Walter. Listen, Hildy, come over here right away. Hold the line a minute. Now, listen, Peggy, please, now, I'm in an awful jam. Don't start to phone me out now, please, honey. Wait a minute, will you? Walter, get this. I can only say this once. I just captured Earl Williams here in the press room. Yeah, honestly, hurry over here. I need you. Right. Hello, Peggy, please. Listen, dear, this is the greatest thing that's ever happened. Wait till I tell you. I just captured Earl Williams, the murderer. Yeah, right. Wait a minute. Please don't tell anybody, honey. I know. But listen, something terrific has happened. It's the greatest thing of my life, honey. Wait. Hold on, never mind. Wait a minute, Molly.
They got them surrounded someplace. Gonna shoot them like a dog.
Get out of here, Molly. They're looking for you, too. If you're smart, you'll get out of here.
Tell me where they've gone. I ain't afraid of them, the yellow murderers.
Lincoln them first.
Oh.
Shh. Who is it?
Me. I've got a clue.
I'll be right with you, wooden shoes.
Get back in there.
What is it? Double cross?
I'm trying to save him.
This is very important.
Keep him quiet. Now, that's a cop, and I'll get rid of him. Hello, wooden shoes.
Here for the roses, Molly.
How'd you get here?
I came down the rain pipe. I didn't mean to shoot him. I don't know what happened.
But you can't stay here. They'll get you.
I don't care anymore.
Well, you gotta hide. Rats.
No, don't do anything. I'm ready to go. I don't care. It's better to die for a cause than the way most people die, for no reason.
Oh, you won't die. They'll never get you.
I ain't important. It's humanity that's important. Like I told you, Molly, humanity is a wonderful thing.
No, it ain't. They're just dirty murderers. Look what they've done to you. And to me.
That's because they don't know any better.
You're too good for them, that's why.
You're good, too.
Me?
Yeah. I think you're wonderful. I wrote out a statement today and left it with the warden. So that when I was dead, people would understand what I meant. There was a lot about you in it. I said you were the most beautiful character I ever met.
Yeah?
So this is a time for you to print my theory of crime prevention.
Okay, you run along and write it out for me. Hurry up, will you? Back there, the fellas are coming. There's no place else.
We'll lock the door.
Coming, Mike.
You've got to get back in there. I got an idea.
Okay.
What's going on in there?
What's going on, dog?
Just 10 minutes.
Open up in there, will you?
All right, all right.
Don't worry. He'll find me anyway.
Quiet, please.
I'll be right here.
Hey! What are you trying to do? Kick down the building?
Can it exclude an agent?
Molly!
Oh, I beg your pardon.
City desk. What's the idea of locking the door?
Well, I was interviewing
the desk.
What is he doing there?
With the blinds down.
Oh, well, you fellas don't understand. You're still here?
Boy,
some Halloween going on out there.
They got the whole police department standing in the rear.
Murphy calling.
Give me the desk.
Any news?
I was never so tired in my life.
They surrounded the house, but Williams wasn't there.
No luck on Williams yet. Call your bank.
Oh, what a chase. Commissioner Frank?
Turner calling.
I'm out with Sheriff Hartman's deputy. Yeah, I'm in a drugstore. Well, call me back if you don't believe me.
Come on, operator.
Fitzroy, 2500.
Molly, can't you flop somewhere else?
Smell.
Bloody filthy.
Makes me passionate.
Look out, she'll start bawling again.
Why don't you let her alone?
Say, when did you two get so chummy?
Told us he was interviewing her.
You back in the job again?
Oh, Sarge. McHugh. Anything doing?
You still here?
Trying to hang something on us, if you ask me.
Well, I'm waiting for Walter. I promised to send a guy over with some dough.
Hey, this looks good. An old lady just phoned the detective bureau and claims Earl Williams is hiding under her piazza.
Tell her to stand up.
Well, just the same, Rose, that sounds like a pretty good tip. Shall we go out on it?
Yeah.
I'll cover this end for you.
Don't let Stewarty boy go out.
Who pulled the shades down?
Molly likes it that way.
Hey, I got a hunch Williams ain't any place they've been looking for him. He might be right here in this building.
Sure, hanging around like a duck in a shooting gallery, I suppose.
Bright guy. Now, there's the skylight he got out of. But how could he get from there to the ground?
I'm pretending to raid in here, Williams.
Look, he'd have jumped over to this roof. That's only about 4 feet.
Yeah, once he got on this roof, he could slide down the rain pipe and come in any of the windows on this side.
Well, if the story's going to walk right in the window...
Well, the mastermind's at work. Why don't you guys go home? Williams will probably call on you.
Well, there must be something in what Ed says, or they'd certainly have nabbed Williams by now. The whole city's inside out looking for him.
Well, if he came in this building, it's a cinch he's still here. There hasn't been a chance for a flea to get through those cops downstairs. Unless it's one that fell off of the sheriff.
What's happened?
Oh, you're still here, Johnson. Thought you were going to New York. Is this the only place you can find to sit in? This chair and this desk are my property, and I won't have anybody using it. Anybody?
We're looking for Roy.
I forgot my aspirin.
Oh, we don't want to get aspirin. It's bad for your heart.
It is, really?
Yes.
I've noticed palpitations every time I've taken some.
What's the matter, Roy? You're sick?
Sick. Say, if I haven't got the grip coming on, I miss my guess.
Get some tonsilin.
Tonsilin?
Yep.
Never heard of it. Any good?
Oh, it's great. It broke up my call in 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
5 minutes.
5 minutes?
Yep.
What was the name?
Tonsilin. T for Kathy, O for Oxen, N for Nuts. Get the tonsilin.
I know how to spell it. Any drugstore?
Any drugstore.
I'll get me some. Oh, that drinking cup.
Hi. Where's Walter, Junior? My dough. Hey, speaking about dough, there's a 10 grand reward for that guy, Williams. Let's get the cops and search the building. What do you say?
Wouldn't it be funny if we found him right here in the building?
Supposing he is here in the building. The cops would grab the reward, we wouldn't get a smell.
That's right.
Listen, let's all grab a floor. Whoever finds him, we'll split the reward.
I'll stay here.
I don't know about that. Get my sunset blown off.
What else is it good for? Besides, he can't hurt anybody.
Oh, come on, Mac.
Now, listen, Mother.
Don't you mother me. If you've got anything to say for yourself, after keeping us at that station all this time, you come downstairs and say to Peggy.
I'll be there in 5 minutes.
No, sir. I don't move out of here without you.
But I already told Peggy.
I know. A lot of gibberish about a murder.
No,
I don't care if you did catch him. You come with me this moment.
I'm sorry. I knew something stuck around here.
Who said he caught him?
What do you mean you caught him?
I don't know what she's talking about. I didn't say anything of the kind.
Yes, you did. Never told her that.
All right, I was trying to catch him. You see, Mother, you got it all balled up.
What do you know about it? How do you know he didn't?
Let's go!
Hilly and she were here together.
Yeah. She's the one that knows.
What do you mean?
Cachet la femme.
Where is Darrell Williams?
How should I know?
Where is he?
We all matter.
Come clean before we knock it out.
Talking, Jimmy!
Who are you trying to cross?
Wait! You slow pigeon! He doesn't know where Williams is. I'm the one that knows.
What do you mean, you know?
Go find out, you heel. You don't think I'm gonna tell?
We'll make you.
Let her alone, she's goofy.
She ain't too goofy to know where Williams is.
Put out of the door!
No, no, you ain't getting out of here.
Now where is
it? Where are you hiding?
I ain't gonna squeal. I ain't gonna.
You gotta tell her. We'll shake it out of you.
Wanna have us call the cops and give you the boot?
Come on, wouldn't you? Slap it out of her.
Where is he? Before I hurt you.
Don't you come near me, you kidney butt.
Keep away.
Keep away from me. I'll knock your head off.
Put down that chair.
Get her out. Get on the side of her.
No, you don't.
never get out of me. I'll never tell. Never!
Grab her.
Carl, get a stretcher.
Take me out of here.
She's moving. She's alive.
Stand back there. Don't touch her.
Get the cops, wouldn't you?
Come on, fellas.
Oh, gee, the poor kid.
Walter, did you see that?
Yes. Where is he?
She jumped out the window.
I know. Where is he, I said?
Oh, anyway, she ain't dead.
Come to, Hildy. Where do you got with him?
Huh? He's in the desk. Oh, the poor kid.
Let me out. I can't stand it. Keep quiet. You're sitting pretty.
What's the matter?
That's my girl's mother.
What are you doing?
Shut up.
I won't shut up. That girl killed herself. Oh, you're doing something wrong. What's in there?
Louis, take this lady over to Paulot Mike's and lock her up. And see that she doesn't talk to anyone on the way.
What's that? What's that?
Take her out the back way. Tell Mike it's a case of delirium tremens.
Oh, this is going to get me in a terrible jam.
Oh, shoot. Anything you say, boss.
Now, don't worry, Mother. This is only temporary.
Where do you think you're going?
Go out and get my girl.
Your girl? What are you, some killing college boy? Why, in time of war, you could be shot for what you're doing now for less.
Colonel, there's your story. Smeared all over the front page. Earl Williams caught by the Morning Post to take all the credit. I covered your story, and they're covering it right. Now I'm getting out of here.
Why, you drooling fathead, what do you mean a story? You've got the whole city by the seat of the pants.
I know, but...
You know, you've got the brain of a pancake. Listen, Hildy, if I didn't have your interest at heart, would I be wasting time arguing with you now? You've done something big. You've set in a new plan.
What?
Why, we'll make such monkeys out of those war dealers that nobody will vote for them, not even their wives.
Expose them, huh?
Crucify them. We're going to keep Williams undercover till morning so the Post can break the story exclusive. Then we'll let the governor and the captain share the glory with him.
I see.
Kicked over the whole city hall like an apple cart. You've got the mayor and Hartland backed against the wall. You put one administration out and another one in. Why, this isn't a newspaper story, it's a career. And you stand there bellyaching about some girl.
Well, yeah, I wasn't thinking about it that way, I guess. We were the white-haired boys, don't we?
Mother, your name is Street after you. Johnson Street. You and I and the governor are going to run this town.
Yeah, we can't keep Williams here. What are the
fellows? Carry him over to my private office. Where's our telephone?
That one. Right over there. How are you going to take him out there? See him?
Not if he's inside the desk, we'll carry it over.
Can't do that. A swarm of cops outside.
We'll lower out of the way. We'll pull it. Hilly, what's that into it? Got that machine stuff running out of
the way. What do you want?
Call the words you got.
Where's the paper? Hello, give me Duffy.
Hello.
Can I call the mayor down on the bay?
Call the lunch time if you want.
Duffy, how about the time you had the house about the fire?
Give him the work. Hello, Duffy. Get set. We've got the biggest story in the world. Earl Williams caught for the Post exclusive. Send word down to Butch McGurk. I want 10 huskies to land right over here. Press room, Colonel Cook building. Butch will get that desk out. Nothing's ever stopped those boys.
Well, let's start shooting.
Fine. Now listen, Duffy. I want you to tear out the whole front page. That's what I said. The whole front page. Out. Johnson's running the lead.
Hilly.
What the devil do you want?
Hilly.
Miss, you can't come in here. Take the Chinese earthquake.
Wait a minute, Duffy. Now look here, little girl.
You're doing this to him. He was going and you stopped him.
Listen, dear, something terrific has happened. I was going to tell you, but I couldn't.
Tell her nothing. She's a woman, you fool.
I'm not going to let you do it. You're coming right now.
Holy jumping.
Johnny, this is the biggest chance of my life.
Keep quiet.
You don't want to marry me, that's all.
That isn't true. Just because you won't listen to me and say you don't love me. When you know I cut off my hands for you, I'd do anything for you, anything in the world.
What, nothing? What? Jump the League of Nations. Break it.
You never intended to be decent and live like a human being. You were lying all the time.
Well, all right, then, if that's what you think.
Take Sebastian jumping and try to concentrate.
Oh, I see what you are now. Just a robber. What's him?
Sure, that's what I am.
Oh, leave the rooster study alone. That's human interest.
You're just a heartless, selfish animal without any feeling. It's all your fault. And if you think I'm going
to
put
shut up, will you?
Let me talk to Butch.
Sure, that's what I am, a rotter, and that's all I ever want to be. Well, then get hold of Butch as fast as you can.
You never had love. Oh, you couldn't talk to me like that.
You want me? You'll have to take what I am instead of trying to make a fool out of me. I'm no stuffed shirt writing peanut ads. I'm a newspaper man.
Let it come, Hildy, fast. Get back in there, you mock turtle.
It isn't going in yet?
Well, don't. Never mind the mail train. You're not working for the advertising department. Keep on this wire.
Oh, nuts.
I told him to stay on the phone. And now the moon's out. Hi. captain is me. Don't forget, you're sitting pretty now. Got enough air? That's it. I'm in, O'Malley. Every punch below the belt. Hello. Duffy, where have you been? Never mind your diabetes. Keep on this phone. Listen, did you imprison on Bush and take a taxi? Did every minute count? You did? All right. Duffy's getting old.
Where is Bush? He's out of the way.
Better hurry the fellas and they come back and phone.
How is she? Don't know yet.
What's your lead, Hildy? While hundreds of Sheriff Hartman's paid gunmen stalked through the city shooting innocent bystanders, spreading their reign of terror, Earl Williams was lurking less than 20 yards from the sheriff's office.
That stinks. Aren't you going to mention the Post? Don't we take any credit?
I got that in the second paragraph.
Who's going to read the second paragraph? 15 years I've been telling you how to write a newspaper story. Have I got to do everything? Get the story, write the story?
Jonathan, you crazy baboon, I could stage better newspaper story than you can write.
You ought to go back to chasing pictures. You were good at that.
Are you ungrateful windbag? Who wrote the Fitzgerald confession? Who wrote the Ruth Randall diary? How about the Dayton flood? Even the telegram operator was crying.
Make me cry now. Duffy, what's the name of that religious editor of ours?
The fellow with the dirty collar. Sipper what? Well, tell Sipperty I want to see him right away.
You know what I'm going to do?
Yeah. Talk yourself to death.
Yeah. I'm going to get Sipperty to make up a prayer for our fair city in 8-column Old English boldface right across the top of the paper. Our Father, there were 421 murders in this our fair city last year. All in religious lingo, see? Our Father, what a prayer. What an idea.
Uh-huh. You better pray that death will float over to your office.
Wait. Wait, wait. I've got an inspiration. Now, here's your lead. Take this down just as I say it.
Someday you're going to do that, and I'm going to belt you right in the jaw.
The Post again rode to the rescue of the city last night in the darkest hour of history. Earl Williams. Earl Williams, the Bolshevik tiger leaps snorting from the gallows upon the flanks of the city. Got you?
I got you, I got you.
Go on from there.
Who's that?
Who's that? What's the idea of knocking the door?
Benzinger. At his desk.
What's his name?
Benzinger.
I'll handle him.
Come on, come on, hey, come on.
Watch. The idea of knocking that door. Haven't you any better sense at all? This isn't a private room, and you ought to know better. Oh, Mr. Burns. Oh, my. It's quite an honor having you over here.
Hello, Benzinger.
Yes. If you'll excuse me, please, I just want to get my...
Quite a coincidence, my running into you tonight. Isn't it, Hildy?
Yeah.
Well, how do you mean? I was just having a little chat about you this afternoon.
That's nice.
Oh, with our Mr. Duffy.
Oh, really? Nothing detrimental, I hope.
Well, I should say not. Say, that was one swell story you had in the paper this morning.
Oh, you liked that, did you? Did you like the poem?
The poem? Oh, the poem was great.
Oh, wasn't it? Well, especially that ending. And all is well outside his cell, but in his heart he hears the hangman calling and the gallows falling and his white-haired mother's tears.
Heartbreaking.
Isn't it?
How would you like to work for me?
Well,
what? We need somebody like you. All we've got over there now are not a lowbrows and leg men like Johnson here.
You serious, Mr. Burns?
My dear Benzinger. Duffy, I'm sending Benzinger over to see you. Mervyn, isn't it?
Roy.
Roy V. Roy Benzinger's a poet. Put him right on the staff. What are you getting in the Tribune, Roy?
75.
I'll give you 100 in the byline. Give him everything he wants. Now, hustle.
Yes, sir.
And write me a story from the point of view of the escaped man. He hides, cowering, afraid of every light, of every sound. He hears footsteps, his heart going like that, and all the time they're closing in. Get the sense of an animal at bay.
A sort of a Jack London style.
Exactly.
Yes, yes. I wonder if you'll excuse me. I just want to get my rhyming dictionary.
It doesn't have to rhyme.
Oh, no, no. I can't tell you, Mr. Burns, how terribly grateful I am. Yes, sir. You don't suppose sometime there might be an opening for a foreign correspondent? I parley a little French, you know.
I'll keep you in mind, Roy.
Oh, thank you, sir. Oh, thank you. Thank you, sir. Au revoir, mon capitaine.
Bonjour.
Oh, Jawa, oh.
White-haired mother's tears. Duffy, get this. The Tribune sneak is coming over to get a job. Benzinger, the fellow I told you about. Tell him to get busy writing poetry. No, we don't want him. Handle with kid gloves till he gets through, then tell him his poetry stinks and kick him downstairs.
Oh, you double-crossing rat.
That will teach him not to quit his job without giving notice.
Quickly.
I beg your pardon.
Back there? Back there?
Yes, I'll be sick on this wire. Kevin, really don't sound like a frozen robin.
Boy, you've just jazzed up my whole life. That's what you've done. You'll have all plans set when Butch gets here.
Butch. He'd go through fire for me.
Mine horse's bustle I turned out to be.
No, the window's out. We'll have some carry it out of the building.
Gee, she was the most wonderful girl I'll ever know. She had looks, brains, spirit, and everything.
Who are you talking about?
My girl, who do you think?
Mumbling about your girl now? You've got a story to write.
In fact, if they chased her out like she was some thicken.
You acted like a man for the first time in your life.
I'll never love anybody else. You don't come twice like that in a man's life.
You can sleep it off.
See, when she was sick in the hospital and you sent me on that wild goose chase all over Kentucky, she never even complained.
Sick in the hospital.
Well, she was. She nearly died.
I see. She never complained. She just nearly died.
Gee, this time tomorrow I'd have been on the train. I'd have been on my way to New York. I'd have been as healthy.
I was in love once.
With my third wife.
I treated her white. Let her have a maid and everything. I was sweet to her.
Oh, who wants to hear about your wife?
I trusted her. Then I later let her meet a certain party in the Tribune, and what happened? One night I came home unexpectedly. I let myself in through the bedroom window. End of story.
I don't want to hear about your troubles.
And the very next morning, what do I read in the Tribune? All over the front page. My attraction story that I've been fool enough to tell my wife.
You know a lot about women, you do. You and that stable you keep. You never met a decent woman. You wouldn't know what to do with a pure girl.
Oh, yes, I would. You take that back! What do you think women are? Flowers? Now, take that dame that shot the dentist. And Mrs. Vermilia. Husband comes home all worn out, hungry, takes a spoonful of soup and falls over dead, arsenic. And Mrs. Petrus, burning her husband up in the furnace. Oh, Hildy, when you've been in this business as long as I have, you'll know what women are. Murderers. Borkers.
Boy, I'm a sap fallen for your line of...
Johnson Street. You've had a good rest. Get back on the story. Here, you're just nervous.
Sure, I'll take that. I'll get sued tonight and I'll stay sued for the rest of my life.
I'll be a newspaper man right in your class. On my bustle and a monkey cage. Shut up, you fathead. Who is it?
Hello. Boss.
Who is it?
What's the matter?
Where's the old lady?
What'd you do with her?
What happened? In the fight?
Down to Western Avenue, 35th Street. We were scoring 65 miles an hour, you know what I mean?
Get that much out of your mouth.
Where's
the old lady?
I'm telling you. We ran a smack into a police patrol, you know what I mean? We caught him in a half.
How was she hurt? Tell me, where is she?
Louis. I'm telling you. Can you imagine bumping into a lot of cops? They come rolling out like the orange.
What did you do with her?
Oh, search me. When I come to, I was running down 35th Street.
But you were with her. You were in a cab with her, weren't you?
Was I? The taxi driver, he's got to knock cold.
By her fingers. I give you an old lady to take somewhere and you hand her over to the cops.
What do you mean, I hand? The police patrol was under the wrong side of the street and they ran.
Now everything's fine. She's probably squawking her head off in some police station.
I don't think she's talking much. You know what I mean?
Well, don't tell me, was she killed? Was she? Did you notice?
Say, with that rap what I got against me, and the bank job, and the big blow right here, I should stick around asking a question from a lot of cops.
Oh, sure. Dead.
Well, that finishes me.
That's fate, Hildy. What will be, will be.
For sure.
Well, what am I going to tell Peggy? What am I going to say to her?
You'll never see her again. Now snap out of it. Would you rather have the old lady dragging the whole police force in here?
But I killed her, I did. What am I going to do? How am I ever going to face her?
Look at you. Look at me.
I'm looking at you, you murderer.
If it was my own mother, I'd carry on. You know I would.
For the paper.
Wait, what did it happen? Because I'm going out. You stay here. I'll find out about everything.
Winston and 24.
Hello, hello.
Give me Weston, 4557.
Who? Oh, hello, Butch. Where are you?
Mission Hospital.
What are you doing there? Haven't you even started?
Was there no lady going there for an honest match-up?
Oh, for H. Sebastian Butch. Listen, it's a matter of life and death. Listen.
Nobody?
I can't hear. You got who? Speak up. A what? Oh, you can't stop for a dame now.
Is this a community hospital?
Butch, I don't care if you've been trying for 6 years. Our whole lives are at stake. Are you going to let some round-heeled blonde ruin everything?
Hello, Eddie. Billy Johnson.
Put my arm in fire for you. Up to here. Now, you can't double-cross me. She does. All right. Put her on. I'll talk to her. Hello.
Oh, hello, madam. Now listen, tramp. You can't keep Butch away from his duty.
What kind of language is that?
Hello. Hello. I'll kill him. I'll kill both of them. Dirty! Mousing around with some big blonde anyone I am. That's cooperation. Dirty! Shut up, will you? You sure, nobody? Dirty! Now, you Venus. I don't know better than to hire anybody with disease. Louis!
Huh?
Up to you.
Anything he wants, boss.
Beat it up and get a hold of the guy, will you?
Where do you want this to get?
Anybody with a hair in the chest. Get off the streets anywhere. Offer him anything, only get him. We gotta get that desk out of here.
Boss? The shirt's off of my back, you know what I mean?
Don't bump into anything! I'll be up to 100.
Some member of you flop on me, I know it. Can you imagine Butch falling down on me at a time like this?
Come on, let's go back to the press room.
Yeah, Ed, tell him to give us a ring there.
Yeah, tell him to ring us in the press room.
Ring us at the press room.
Louis, don't get back in 5 minutes. We'll give that alarm. That minion's away. We'll start a fire. Have the fireman carry it out. The confusion. Bring that number, will you?
Come here. See if we can move it.
Hello, is this the lying-in hospital? Did you have an auto smash up in the lab?
Will you come here?
Oh, I see. Well, I beg your pardon.
When I'm surrounded with my back against the wall, you're not going to lay down on me.
I'm going to lay down on you and spit in your eye, you murderer.
Yellow, huh?
I don't care what you think I am. I'm going to find my girl's mother. Oh.
Your girl. You and Butch McGurk. Woman lover.
Going out and find her.
Don't open that. Here he is.
Oh, well, tell me. Just a minute, John.
Let go of me. What's the idea?
What's the hurry?
Wait a minute. We want to see you.
Keep your paws off of me, will you?
Tell him, all right.
Wait a minute, Hartman. Wait a minute.
Who do you think you are breaking in here like this?
You can't bluff me, Burns. I don't care who you are or what paper your editor of.
Let me go. Fellas, something's happened to my girl's mother.
Hang on to him, boys.
We know what you're up to.
I'm literally going out to get Williams.
The door was locked.
He and Monica talking.
I don't know anything. I tell you, there's been an accident.
Johnson, there's something very, very peculiar going on here.
Well, you can send somebody out with me if you don't believe me.
I wasn't born yesterday. Now, the boys tell me that you and this Molly Malone.
Oh, nobody's trying to put anything over on you. I'm going to get out of here. You can't stop me.
Hey, you ain't going to get anywhere. Sheriff, he's got the whole story sewed up, and that's why Burns. That's why Burns is here.
We're not here. We're in town.
If you've any accusations to make, Hartman, make them in the proper manner. Otherwise, I'll have to ask you to get out.
You'll ask me to what?
Get out.
Close that door. Don't let anybody in or out.
Come on, Pinky, give him a little third degree.
Make him talk, Pinky. You've got Williams.
Johnson, I'm going to the bottom of it. Tell me, what do you know about William? Are you going to talk or ain't you?
What do I know about Williams?
All right, boys, take him along. I got ways of making him talk.
Look out, Joe!
Oh, what's the use of fighting, Hilly?
Get out, he's got a gun! Hey, Walter!
Give me that. Where'd you get this?
Don't have to carry a gun if I want.
Not this gun.
I can explain that, Hartman. He was having some trouble on the spray case. I gave it to him to defend himself.
Oh, you did, eh? Well, that's very, very interesting. This happened to be the gun that Earl Williams shot his way out with.
Oh, getting married, huh?
Maybe Williams is going to be his best man.
That's pretty, Hildy. Crossing your own pal. What do you know about that, eh?
Are you trying to make me out a liar?
I know my own gun, don't I?
Oh, we might have known who'd give Williams a gun.
Did you ever make a mistake?
Oh, now we're getting the story.
Then Hilly got that gun from Earl Williams. Where is he? Where are you got him?
You're barking up the wrong tree, Hartman.
I'll give you 3 minutes to tell me where he is.
You know, at the hospital, the corner of Professor Egelhofer.
What?
At the Bank of Marshmallow.
Take a magazine along.
He ain't there.
Say, what about Mr. Burns? Ask the mastermind what he's doing here.
Speak up, Burns. What do you know about this?
My dear Hartman. Oh, can that. Come on now, where is he? The Morning Post is not obstructing justice or aiding criminals. You ought to know that.
No? Well, Johnson, you're under arrest. You too, Burns.
Who's under arrest, you insignificant pimple-headed square-toed spy? Do you realize what you're doing?
We'll see about that. Carl, get the mayor on the phone. Ask him to come over here.
That man there.
Tell me, Mother, are you all right?
What's the idea here?
This lady claims she was kidnapped.
What?
They dragged me all the way down the stairs.
Just a minute, lady. What does this man to do with it?
He was the one in charge of everything. He told them to kidnap me.
Are you referring to me, madam?
You know you did.
What about this, Burns? Kidnapping, eh?
Well, it's beyond me. Who is this woman?
What a thing to say. I was standing right there when the girl jumped out of the window.
Did you get the mayor on the phone, Carl?
Yeah. Coming right over.
Now, madam, be honest. If you were joyriding, drunk, or got into some scrape, why don't you admit it? Instead of accusing innocent people.
Oh, corruption. You unprincipled man. You, how dare you say a thing like that?
Oh, Mother, he's just crazy.
I tell you why they did it.
Come on, Jerry, we've got to get back.
I'm in this room. They had some kind of murderer hiding him.
Hiding him? In here?
Hiding him where?
Oh, Mother!
Where was he? Where the heaven?
Madam, you're a cockeyed liar.
He's in the desk. Holy cat.
For the love of...
Stephanie!
Give me that phone.
What a break.
I thought so. Stand back, everybody.
How?
They have a cop. Get your guns out.
No, he's harmless.
Don't take any chances. Shoot right through the desk.
He can't hurt anybody. You've got his gun.
Oh, dear.
Gray-haired old weasel.
City desk, quick. Close that door. Give me the desk. Guard that window.
City desk, hurry.
You, stand over there.
Hey, the coward, you're pointing that gun.
Give me ammo.
Hilly, call Duffy. Duffy!
No, you don't.
Let me have the desk, quick. You want to get a scoop?
Now, everybody.
Hold the wire, I got a flash point.
Aim right at the center.
That's murder.
When I say three...
Hang on for a second.
Oh, Frank,
hold it.
One of you stand each side of the desk.
Something coming up.
Take hold of the cover.
Hold the phone.
We got you covered, William.
I'll have it in a minute.
Ready for an emergency.
Right away now.
When I count three...
Something hot.
One. Two. Up with it.
Shoot me!
Earl Williams, just captured the French room in the criminal court building, hiding in the desk.
Gotcha, Williams.
Williams found an old cop?
That was hiding. Found Williams hiding place?
Williams put up a desperate struggle, but the police overpowered.
He offered no resistance.
They tried to shoot it out with the cops. The gun wouldn't work, so...
Trying to break through the
court
of police.
Impossible,
so
they opened the desk.
Dummy! The post just turned Williams over to the sheriff. Four in a minute.
Put the cops on those two. Anonymous note received by the sheriff that Williams capture. More later.
Well-dressed society woman tipped off the cops. Call you back.
Old sweetheart of Williams double-crossed.
Following a well-defined trail of blood, the sheriff, Williams gave away his whereabouts when he sent out the
phone. Sheriff is now tracing a mysterious phone call to give away Williams' hiding place. Call you back.
Where's the old lady?
Hey, madam.
Where'd she go?
Where's the old lady?
Hello, girlie. Give me Jacoby, quick.
Hartman, you're going to wish you'd never been born.
Fine work, Pete. You certainly delivered the goods. I'm proud of you.
They look kind of natural, don't they, eh, Fred?
A sight for sore eyes. Well, it looks like you boys stepped into something up to your necks.
Aiding an escaped criminal. And a little charge of kidnapping that I'm looking into. That's the jail. There must be somebody there.
Hey,
there's the old lady now.
Well, it looks like about 10 years apiece for you, Burge.
Does it? You forget the power that always watches over the Morning Post.
Your luck's not with you now.
Jacoby, I caught him. William. Yeah, single-handed. They're bringing him right over. We'll proceed with a hanging first schedule.
You'll be in office exactly 2 days more. And we're pulling your noses out of the feed bag.
Give me the district attorney's office. I'll tell you what you'll be doing. You'll be making brooms in the state penitentiary. Hello, Durant. This is Hartman talking. Come over to my office right away, will you? I just arrested a couple of important birds, and I want you to take their confessions.
Duffy, get Clarence down!
All the lawyers in the world aren't going to help you.
This is the Morning Post.
You're talking to?
The power of the press, huh?
Bigger men than you have found out what the power of the press means. Presidents. Yes, and King. Fred, whenever you think you've got the post licked, that's a good time to get out of town.
On a hand car.
Whistling in the dark, eh? Well, it isn't going to help you this time. You're through.
The last man that told me that was Eddie Kane, a week before he cut his throat. And I've got the same feeling right now that I had 5 minutes before that happened.
Here's your reprieve.
Get out of here.
You can't bribe me.
What's all this?
Get out of here, you.
I won't. Here's your reprieve.
What?
I don't want to be your steady stealer.
Who is this man?
Who was bribing you?
They wouldn't take it.
You're insane.
What did I tell you? The unseen power. What's your name?
Irving Pinkett.
You drunken idiot. Arrest him.
The idea of coming here with a cock and bull story like that.
It's a frame-up. Some imposter.
Hey, wait a minute.
Murder, eh?
Hanging an innocent man to get an election, huh?
It's a lie.
I never saw him before.
Why, Fred, when did you deliver this the first time?
They started right in bribing me.
Who's they?
Them. That's absurd in the face of it, Mr. Burke.
He's talking like a child.
The unseen power. He's insane or drunk or something. Since this unfortunate man Williams has really been reprieved, I personally am tickled to death. Aren't you, Pete?
Huh? Oh, you'd hang your mother to win an election.
That's a horrible thing to say, Johnson, about anybody. Now, look here, Walter. You're an intelligent man.
Wait a minute. All right, Mr. Pinkus, let's have your story.
Well, I've been married 19 years.
Let's skip all that.
Take those handcuffs off the boy's feet. That wasn't at all necessary.
I was just going to. Well, what are you waiting for? Why don't you take the cuffs off the boys?
Walter, I can't tell you how badly I feel about this. There was no excuse for Pete to fly off the handle.
I was only doing my duty. There wasn't anything personal.
Why don't you guys quit politics and take in washing?
What did you say your name was? Pinkus?
That's right. Here's a picture of my wife.
Fine-looking woman.
Why, she's good enough for me.
Boy, I'll bet she is.
Tell me, what's the matter? What are they going to do? Those reporters said
that... Peggy, don't start to blow me out now.
Nobody's going to do anything to anybody.
Of course not. My old friend Walter Burns and I understand each other perfectly, I trust.
And so do I.
So do you what? You hoodoo. And now, Mr. Pickett, if you'll come with us, we'll take you over to the Wharton's office and deliver this reprieve.
But tell me, they said they'd arrested you.
We were going to have a little feed, Walter, after the hanging. A sort of a buffet breakfast.
Arthur!
I'm coming, Fred. What do you say if we eat it now? Delicious ham and some of Mrs. Hartman's own preserves.
Hartman!
Oh, dear.
Wait till those two read the post in the morning. Did we get that guy Pinkus over to the office tomorrow?
Nothing doing. I'm all washed up.
What's that?
I mean it this time, Walter.
Oh, Hildy, if I only thought you did.
Peggy, if I'm not telling the absolute truth, may I fall dead. I'm going to New York tonight with you, if you'll give me this one last chance. I'm going to cut out drinking and swearing and everything connected with that crazy newspaper business. Honey, I'll never even read a newspaper.
I've got an idea.
No, sir. Nothing you can say will ever change my mind. This time I'm through and I mean it. Peggy, I got a lot of nerve to ask you to marry me. I'm a prize package, all right, but if you'll take me, here I am.
Darling, don't talk that way. I want you just the way you are.
Gosh, Hildy, I didn't know it was anything like this. Why didn't you say something? I'm the last person in the world to want to step between you and your happiness. You ought to know that. I love you, you crazy mug. You're getting a great guy, Peggy.
Yeah, well, never mind the Valentine. Goodbye, you turkey.
You're a great newspaper man, Hildy. And I'm sorry to see you go.
Well, if I ever come back to the business, which I won't, there's only one guy I'd work for. You know that, don't you?
I'd kill you if you ever worked for anybody else.
You hear that, Peggy? That's my diploma. Gee, Walter, I don't know what to say except I'm going to miss you.
Same here, son.
15 years we've been laughing around together. That's before you were born, honey.
And what jams we've been in. And what excitement we've had.
Say,
Do you remember the time we hid the missing heirs from the sauerkraut factory?
Do I? Say, Peggy, get him to tell you about the time that we stole Olivia Hagley's stomach from the coroner's physician.
We proved she'd been poisoned.
We had a hide for a week.
Darling.
What?
You don't want to go to New York. Down deep.
Well, I was just talking. I'd feel worse if I stayed, I guess.
If I thought you were going to be unhappy. I mean, if you really wanted to... No. This is your chance to have a home and be a human being. And I'm going to make you take it.
I wouldn't let him stay. Go on before I make you city editor.
Hurry up, Peggy. He means it.
Any objections to my kissing the bride?
No, it's okay with me. Go ahead, Mrs. Johnson.
Thanks. What time does your train go?
There's another 12:40.
New York Central, eh? Gee, I wish I had time to buy you a little wedding present. Wait a minute. I've got it.
Oh, no, Walter. Gee, you make me feel like I'm the bride.
Shut up. It's a present from the big chief himself. And if you look inside, you'll find a little inscription. The best newspaper man I know. And when you get to New York, you can scratch out my name and put yours in his place if you want to.
You know I wouldn't do that.
Take it, Hildy. Mr. Burns wants you to. You don't want to hurt his feelings.
Well, this is the first and last thing I ever got from a newspaper.
Goodbye. I've always had a queer opinion of you, Mr. Burns. In fact, I still think you're a little peculiar, but you're all right underneath. I mean, I think you're a peach.
So are you. You look just like a little flower.
Goodbye, you big baboon.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Johnson. Be good to yourself and the little girl.
Same to you and many others.
Duffy. Listen, Duffy. What's the first stop of the 12:40 to New York? That's right. I want you to send a wire to the chief of police there. Tell him to stop that train and arrest Hildy Johnson. Bring him back here. Wire him a full description. The son of a... Stole my watch.